Hello everyone and welcome to this Masterclass Smash Your Job Hunting. Welcome everyone. I know there's plenty of people that are going to be joining from different countries, from UK, from Spain, from Italy, all around Europe, from the US as well, from Asia. So let's give them a few minutes just to make sure that we have all participants here. I always like to be respectful with everyone's time. So to make sure that we cover all what we need to cover today, which is going to be a lot, I promise. And also waiting for the few that could be a little bit delay. So while we wait for the rest, I'm looking at the number of participants now. Let me introduce myself while I share my screen as well. This is Nieves Rodriguez, and I'm certified career success coach, and I'm going to be sharing with you today the system that I can promise you that works to be successful in your job search. And why I am so passionate about this subject is because, you know, while we wait for the others to join, I'm going to explain you a little bit about myself. And though this is for you, and I promise we are going to have a full hour, you know, sharing the system and sharing a lot of templates and tools that are going to be useful for you to be successful in your job search. But let me tell you a little bit about myself so you understand why I'm so passionate about this matter. As I mentioned, I'm a career coach and certified career coach. And 7 years ago, when I did my master's in career coach, I also used this tool that I'm going to be sharing with you to do 180 degrees, U-turn in my personal and professional career. 7 years ago, when I decided to quit a job after 25 years, quite a good senior role in a very good company, in a multinational company. And after starting my coaching master and using the system that I'm going to be sharing with you, I actually realized that I was wasting my time during my plus 30 years of professional experience, actually thinking and using different systems that didn't work for me in my career move. So I'm a certified career coach, but also being in that side on the table, I've been going through a lot of interviews, like probably you are going through now. And I've been also hiring a lot of people. So actually what I'm going to be sharing with you today is actually, I'm going to bring all my experience as a career coach, as an interviewer, and as a person that has been interviewed many times, and I know how frustrated that could be. But before we continue, can you just, I'm sure it's not the first Zoom session that you attend in the last 12 months, but if just to make sure I'm not talking on my own, on to myself, if you can just confirm that you can actually listen to me, that you can hear me well. If you can say yes, Nieves, we can hear you well, that will be amazing. I'm gonna be keeping the Q&A open during the masterclass just to make sure I answer all your questions. But I can promise you that we have a lot of content. So I'm going to keep an eye on it. But if we don't have time through the masterclass, I promise we will have time at the end to cover all the questions you may have. So thank you very much for confirming. So let's get started. So again, welcome. I think we have most of the participants now. So we are going to be talking today about is how to smash your job hunting and get the job actually you want in three steps. And I think what is more important is without actually getting frustrated. Because my goal today with you is to change that mindset of you know, be searching for a job versus get the job that actually you want, or begging sometimes for a job. I'm sure you had that feeling as well, begging for a job versus getting the job you actually want. So this is the mindset I really, is my goal. I would really like to change today. Because, and what is, for whom is this masterclass is for those, and this system for those that are unemployed and searching for a work, for could be for those that want to change jobs within the same or another industry. It could be those seeking for a promotion, or it could be for those wanting to shift from a job to becoming an entrepreneur. That's absolutely fine, because this is the system to be successful in your career. And that doesn't mean you need to be unemployed. That doesn't mean you need to now be currently looking for or actively looking for a job. I promise it's going to help you, or could help you, to be successful in the rest of your career. If you, while we wait for a few others, if you don't, this is, you know, in this environment, we need to be feeling very safe. So the way you can answer the question could be anonymous. But anyway, the way I set it up, because it's a kind of, you know, career, a path, a masterclass, I want to you to feel safe. So actually, you write a question or you write a comment, it's going to be only you and me seeing that comment. I will read the question, so everyone actually can learn from each other. But I just want you to feel safe to ask me whatever you feel you need to ask me, or whatever is not clear enough for you. So while we wait for others and while we continue, if you don't mind to tell me, what is your current situation? Are you unemployed? Are you actually thinking about your next career move? Are you actually looking for a promotion, or are you actually thinking about breaking free and maybe become an entrepreneur? If you can write it down for me, that would be good, because in that way I can actually pay more attention in the different areas of the masterclass. So thank you very much. Just looking for a job and currently unemployed. Okay. Thinking about my career plan. Perfect. Okay. I want to learn more about curriculums. That's fine. No worries. We will cover that as well. Unemployed, internship. Okay. Looking for a job. Okay. So we have part-time job, looking for full-time job with high, let me see, with high expectations. Okay. Unemployed, for a new role, following the redundancy. Okay. That's really, really helpful. So thank you very much. This is going to help you absolutely. Everyone, doesn't matter in what situation you are, is going to absolutely help, or that's my intention. And this is the system that works for the rest of your career. Again, it's not only for those that are unemployed. And I'm going to share with you a framework that if you follow it, you will be, I can promise you can be successful, but you have to be consistent. So why are you here? Probably because you don't have clarity of what to do. Probably because you're not sure what CV or cover letter you have to use, could be that as well. Probably because, you know, some of them you may be applying to many roles, but they don't invite you to an interview. I've been there as well, and I know what the feeling is like, you know, I'm sending CVs, but nobody's inviting me to an interview. Or maybe you are having many interviews but never get an offer. That's all also actually the case for many people, that they are very successful with the CV. They have a very good CV, but for some reason, they don't go through the interview. So what I'm going to share with you today is not the conventional method. So the agenda is going to be in three steps. The step one is understand what you want to do. And the reason why is step one is because you really need to understand what you want to do in your career, what you want to do in your next move, because if you don't know what you're going to do, it's going to be very difficult to have a CV or cover letter or a LinkedIn profile that is going to stand out. And it's going to be very difficult for you to actually do a proper search. And it's very difficult for you to convince the person that is looking at you, at your CV, or the person that is interviewing, to actually offer you the job. So step number one is highly, highly important. Step number two is, once you know what you want to do, once you know what is going to be your professional goal, then we will get into customizing your CV, your cover letter, and work on your network and start talking about those conversations, career conversation with your network. And then the step three is, once you have all your marketing plan or your personal brand, which is the CV, the personal letter, and your LinkedIn profile, then we are going to move what we need to prepare to be successful in this in the job hunting. Obviously, we have an hour. I'm going to do my best, but I promise take notes, have your phone, your smartphone with you, because you may need to take pictures, because I'm going to share with you a lot of templates. And but definitely what I want to highlight is the job hunting, opposite to what many people think, it is not just the CV and a cover letter. It's almost a science. When I learned the system that I share with you, again, as a certified career coach, it was like day and night. I realized that I've been wasting a lot of my time when I was doing my job search in the past. And that's why I'm very passionate about it. And I'm really feel your frustration. And that's why I do these masterclasses, because I really want to help people that are in the same situation. So in the step one, you have to create a solid foundation. You're going to build that confidence. I'll tell you how. In the step two, you're going to build your personal brand, and we are going to work on productivity, because less is more in the job hunting. And in the step three, we are going to smash the interview with some things that you have to prepare no matter what. So let's get to work. Have a notebook, have your iPhone, smartphone, whatever with you, so you can take pictures. Have a lot of energy. It's going to be very intense. I may ask you some questions so I can drink a little bit of water. And commitment as well. Let's have the commitment to put into practice the things you're going to learn, please. I've been putting a lot of effort into this presentation, but I really want you to put that effort as well and that commitment and practice, put into practice what you're going to learn, because it doesn't matter if you know it. What it matters is if you do it. So let's have that commitment together, because I really want to help you. And I want you to have an open mind as well, because you're going to have a completely different approach. Probably you're going to hear new things that you haven't heard in the past. And of course, a little bit of fun, that's not gonna hurt. Interview, no offer, sorry to interrupt, I am audible, your voice properly, maybe network issues, hopefully it is no me. Okay, so let me know if anyone else has issues with my voice, probably network. I'm in London, and whenever it's cloudy, I don't know if it's cloudy or not, the network is not very well. But let me know if someone else cannot hear me well. So if you are ready, I highly recommend that you take a picture or look at this link, because I'm going to be sharing with you something that I think is going to help you to really be successful in your job hunting. So let's start with step number one. And apologies if I'm going very fast, but I really, really want to cover all what I want to share with you again, because I really want to help you to be successful and just leave behind all this frustration. So the goal of the step, the first step, is to understand what you want to do. Because less is more when you are searching for a job, and when you're thinking about your career move, or even if you're thinking about becoming an entrepreneur. Less is more, but less is better. So we are going to be created like a funnel. A funnel is very important, because with most of my coaching clients, when they start working with me, some of them, they tell me they've been applying for 50 jobs a day. They have been applying to 100 jobs a day. It's impossible. If you're doing that, and I hope no, just stop it, because you're doing something wrong. Because in order to be successful, you really need to customize absolutely all your application. You need to customize your CV. So if you're applying to many jobs, if you don't have a clear career goal, stop it. It's better to stop, slow down, to move forward. So less is more, but less is better. So we are going to create that funnel, because your new job is searching for a job. And the results you're going to get are going to be always proportional to your investment. That is no doubt. But what is really sad is 90% of the people work on something that actually they don't like. And probably you heard this from Einstein, that everyone is a genius, but if you judge a fish but its ability to climb a tree, it will live its whole life believing that is stupid. And actually that is true, and that is happening. And my question to you is, have you thought about what makes you happy at work in your life, generally speaking, but now we are talking about career here. What do you actually enjoy? The sad thing is that most of us, you know, we study something, but we end up working in something else. And success is when we dedicate ourselves to what we actually enjoy, both personally and professionally speaking. And actually, it is possible. But the problem is that school, we learn and develop a lot of academic stuff, very, you know, important academic stuff, but we never understand our strengths, our talents, and how our work minds. So gladly, can you enjoy projects you do for fun? Yes, Diana, of course. Yeah, of course you can enjoy. So first of all, you need, in this first step, it's going to be very important to understand yourself, to understand what you want to do in your career, because unless you know what you want to do, and sometimes I know it could be sounds a little bit weird, but sometimes we need someone to actually, you know, help us to move forward with some redundancies, or when, you know, some companies are shrinking, sometimes when we are unemployed, actually you need to think and you need to become the victim of your future. And it's an opportunity. I know there are some financial, you know, you need to look at your financials. And obviously we all have to pay our rent or our invoices at the end of the month. But sometimes this is the opportunity to redesign your future. So take this opportunity, or even if you still have a job and you're thinking about your next career move, just make sure you do it in the right way. Make sure you actually follow what you need to follow. We all have 24 strengths, and usually we don't take them into account when we are thinking about our career or we are thinking about our job search. And, you know, if you want to take a picture, I will share the video anyway tomorrow when it's in YouTube. But if you want to take the picture, I'm not affiliate of this company. It's a company that I work with. I've done some studies, some mindfulness studies at Yale University. And they work with this organization. And it's really, really good service. It takes like 10 minutes and actually give you, because we all have those 24 strengths, it gives you your top four and actually give you the combination of all your strengths. And actually it gives you tips about how to use your strengths at work and what type of work you could use actually to be happy at work. And actually happiness is when you are in that flow. Probably you've heard when you're in that flow and you can actually apply these strengths in your life and work as well. So another thing in the step number one to really do before you start doing a job search, it's really understanding your values. I have a lot of tools that I will talk to you about later, but actually it's very important to understand what are your values and what are the company values that you're currently working for, or actually the company values that for the companies you're going to be applying for. You know, most of them now they have their values published. You know, a different thing is whether they put them into practice or not, but it's very important you think about what are your values, what the companies before we start looking for a job. Transferable skills in this part of the self-evaluation is very important. And in transferable skills is very important. And I will talk later, especially if you're going to be changing industry or you're thinking about changing to a different sector. And we are going to use it a lot. A lot of the things we are going to be covering in step number one, we are going to use them a lot in the CV and in the cover letter. And we are going to use them a lot in the LinkedIn profile. So really spend quality time doing these exercises to really think about your personality, thinking about your transferable skills, because that's going to build a lot of your confidence when building the CV, when building LinkedIn, and when actually talking during the interview. So you really need to understand, you know, this is a very simple template, but you really need to understand what are your transferable skills, because again, if you don't know your strengths, if you don't know your transferable skills, it's going to be very difficult that you put them in the CV, or it's going to be very difficult to put it on the LinkedIn or talk about them during the interview. During the presentation, if you see a star and I forget, this is one of the things where I see most of the people, they do it wrong. And this is achievements. I'm going to talk about this a tool, which is SOAR, which probably you have heard before. It's S-O-A-R, or STAR as well. Some people that refer to it as a STAR. It's very important to know about your accomplishment is STAR, is because, again, that's going to help you to build your confidence. It's going to help you to build the CV, because when you build on your STAR or your SOAR, we are going to take the R results. SOAR is for situation, obstacles, actions, and results. We are going to take the R and we are going to take it to the CV. That's the achievements. That's the part of the CV. It has to be very solid, very strong, because when someone is looking at your CV, they don't want to see responsibilities. Actually, they want to see the achievements, what contribution you had in your last company, because that way they will see what contribution you could actually do if they offered you the job. So it's very important that you work on your accomplishment. I always suggest for my coaching clients to work between 20 and 30 stars or SOARs or accomplishments to cover their CV, to cover the transferable skills, and always have stars or SOARs achievements for the job description for the role they are applying for. Very important, and that's going to give you a lot of, believe me, when you work on 20, 30 accomplishments, that's going to give you a lot of confidence, and that's going to give you a lot of confidence to build that CV, put in a lot of achievements, we'll cover that later, and that's going to give you a lot of confidence to really stand out during the interview. Personal characteristics, again, very important that you do that work, because, for example, if you want to be a leader and you are very introvert, that is, you know, obviously you can be a good leader, be introvert, but maybe you're going to have a lot of effort, or, you know, maybe you're someone that you want to be an individual contributor and you apply for a lead or supervisor, a position. So there are a lot of things you really need to think about your personal characteristic before you apply for a job, because the last thing you want to do is to have changing jobs, because believe me, that's not going to look good in your CV. That's going to make your career a path more difficult in the future, and it's going to give you probably a lot of frustration. So that's very important. You really understand yourself. Working conditions, believe me, that is one of the things a lot of people, I see a lot of people, those that, as I mentioned before, they send a lot of CVs, they apply for jobs without actually knowing whether they like the working condition or if they understand the working condition. So again, before you start looking for a job or your next career move, even if you are employed, think about what type of job you want. Do you want to work for a big company, for a small company? You want to have, again, an individual contributor. You want to supervise people. You want to work in a small team, a big team. You like to work in a team. Do you want to commute? Do you want to work from home? Don't know. Most of us, we're working from home. But it's very important, because otherwise you're going to be sending hundreds of CVs when in reality, maybe half of them actually, they don't suit you. There are no roles that actually you want to apply for. And you are wasting all that energy applying for the jobs when in reality, what you need to do again is less is more. We need to create that funnel and apply it to less jobs, because it's going to give you the energy to do it properly, to do it with attention to detail, and you're really to stand out. And then also the career chart. Very few people, they do this career chart. Very simple. Something that I want to share with you, something that you need to understand in your professional goal, what you want to do, what you don't want to do, and you may want to do. Also, it's very important as well to the target market. It's very important to have your target market. I always suggest to have between 20 and 30 target companies, the ones that you're going to be really, really looking for and applying for jobs, doing research, you know, setting up your profile in their website and applying and putting alerts on LinkedIn. Target market, that way you're going to have very laser, I call it laser focus, job search. But the same, you need to think about what you don't want, what you may want, and what do you really want? And other requirements, like I mentioned before, what type of work environment, what type of logistic do I want to commute? I don't want to commute. So it's very important you do these career goals, a scenario before you actually start, you know, thinking about your next move. And then in the end, in this first step, you are going to have this self-evaluation summary. You know, you're going to take your top three skills and competencies, your top three characteristics, other important aspects, to your top three values, and you're going to come up with two professional goals, only with two. Again, less is more. You have to really understand what your career goals are. Otherwise, you're going to be applying to many jobs and you're not going to be able to transmit your message during the interview. I promise you that. Or your CV is going to be too broad and you're not going to capture the attention of the reader. So it's very important you come up with two professional goals. And then if you see at the end of the form as well, for those two professional roles, I want you to think about what type of experience, what type of achievements, what type of personal skills, what type of transferable skills actually support me to really look to professional goal A and the same for professional B. So if you see it here in the step number one, actually you have done a self-evaluation about, you know, your strengths, your weaknesses, your personal characteristic, what you want to find in a company, what type of job, and you're going to come up with one summary that actually, again, is going to give you that laser focus that you really need to for a job, to do a proper job search or be successful in your job hunting. And then positioning statement is very important. Positioning statement, probably you've heard about elevator pitch. Elevator pitch is this 20 seconds that we have. Imagine that you meet the CEO of the company, of your dream company, the company you want to work with, and you meet that person at the elevator and you have 20 seconds to introduce yourself. Or imagine the same, but in a networking or in a cocktail or in a networking event, you have 20 seconds to describe yourself. Again, this is the structure. If you want to take a picture, you need to follow. And again, if you're not capable of describing yourself in 20 seconds, it's going to be very difficult to transmit that in the interview. Because in the interview, the typical question, the first question, we will cover that later, is tell me about yourself. So this positioning statement is going to help you actually to have a very clear message. Remember, during job hunting, you're going to be like a politician, a good politician. You really need to transmit what you want to transmit, and you need to transmit what they want to hear, something they want to hear. Sorry. Sometimes we forget that. So you need to put the hat of the hiring manager and talk in their language, actually. Tell them what they want to hear without lying. That's very important. So positioning statement is very important. It's going to give you, once you finish with your self-evaluation, it's going to give you a lot of confidence. It's going to help you, with the CV, and it's going to help you during the interview process. And with all that, you are going to have a marketing plan. You are going to have, you know, your professional goal. You are going to have your positioning statement, and you are going to have, you know, very clear experience outlined for each of the objectives you are going to have. So you're going to have a very clear message when you're speaking to the people during an interview or over a telephone conversation. But very important to have the target market. So my challenge to you is always find 20, 30 companies and between 5 and 10 recruitment agencies or headhunters and focus on those. It's about going deeper and not going broader. It's really about going deeper and talk to people a lot. And we'll talk about networking a little bit later. And then productivity report is one of those things that many people don't do. Your new job is to find a job. So unless you measure your performance and how many hours you are actually investing, it's going to be very difficult for you to see their results. I always say to my coaching clients that, you know, I can tell which one they're going to find the job first and which ones they're going to take a little bit longer, because it depends on not only on the number of hours, but also the quality and the follow-up and how many people they talk to. So this is step number one. As you can see, it's really the building blocks, really understanding what you want to do. And once you understand what you want to do, then you can move on. But you, first of all, you start just to slow down. I know we all have to pay the bills and it's really struggling. I've been there when I've moved countries, you know, a few years ago. And sometimes they look at you even after 25 years, they tell me you don't have experience. Hello, okay. And I know how frustrating it is. But I also understand when I started working in my area of control and actually building my confidence, working on my achievement and my source, and working on how to actually transmit my message, that is when I was successful getting a job. So believe me, that first step is the building block. It's very, very important. Then once you have that clear objective, then we can move to the step number two, which is adjusting and building your personal brand, adjusting your CV, your personal letter, and doing the networking. You have 6 seconds because the curriculum, your curriculum, your resume is read by a robot. I call it robot, but it's actually a software. So how many people, and I drink water, how many people knew that your CV most of the time, it's really depend on the role you're applying, most of the time is read by or is filtered by a robot or a software? Mm-hmm. I did. Some people, yes. Some people, no. There's a little bit of mix. Now is in the digital area, that is most commonly known, but you know, a few years ago, not many people knew that. And it's very important just to know that actually your CV most of the time is read by a robot. Now, because we apply in platforms, we apply in LinkedIn, et cetera, you have 6 seconds for that software to read your message, to really spot your keywords. And we will talk about keywords a lot. And you have 30 seconds if you have a human being reading your CV. So it's about becoming a victim of the circumstances. I'm thinking about nobody's reading my CV. Or actually it's about actually becoming an actor and actress. And what I mean by that is that, again, less is more, but less is better. So I don't want you to send 50 curriculums and 100 curriculums. I want you to send 20, but actually you need to adapt each of your CVs and cover letter for each of the roles that you are applying. Otherwise, you're not gonna pass the filter of the robot or the software or even the human being. So it's very important. And if you apply for 50 roles or 100 roles a day, that's very difficult, if not impossible, to really do a good job. So you're wasting your time. So think about this, and that's why this first step is very important, because once you know what you want to do, you are going to create those filters in the agencies, in the platforms, in LinkedIn, even with the headhunters, and you are going to apply to less roles, because you're going to be applying only to the roles that actually fit your needs, the ones you really want. Sometimes, you know, and We all have done it. Sometimes we need to work because, again, we need to pay our bills. But always think about the long-term plan. If you actually need to get a job and to pay the bills, which again, we all need, always have a final destination in mind in your GPS. Keep working on your final destination. Keep working on your dream job, because again, we are going to be, you know, the average age probably is, you know, we still have 30, some of you 40 or even more years to continue working. So we work for all our lives. It's very important that we feel fulfilled in our professional career. So there are two types of curriculums. I don't know if you know where it, you can tell me yes or not. There are chronological and functional CVs. Algorithm use a text mining to check it. Hussam, you got it. I wouldn't be able to express it that way, but machine learning algorithm use the text mining to check it. That's good, Hussam Raja. Thank you very much. Did you know that there's, you know, a few types of CVs? The reason I'm asking is because most of the people, they use the chronological CVs, when in reality, they need to use the functional CV or resume. Did you know that? Have you heard Music Job Seer and Job Scan? Exactly. So there are a few CS and no. Some people have heard about functional CVs, some people no. Okay, so let me explain to you. So chronological CVs is when you have experience, when you have a solid experience in an industry, in a country, and you have been working in a company with a very good reputation that, you know, if anyone's that reads your CV, they are going to recognize that company. However, if you want to change your industry, you want to change sector, if you had gap years where you didn't work, or you have been changing a lot, or maybe you haven't worked because you were on maternity or maternity leave, then you need to work on your functional CV. And I see a lot of people that they should be using the functional CV and they're still using the chronological CV. And that is why they don't get invited to attend interviews, because they are using the wrong CV. So they are very similar. The chronological, the one on the right-hand side, is a typical that, you know, it's going by chronological order. And you're going to be talking in chronological order about in the companies you've been working in at. So again, you are highlighting your experience in a sector, you are highlighting experience in a specific sector or industry. However, if you're changing the industry or countries, et cetera, you should be using the functional. In the functional CV, while you're going to be standing, you're going to be talking more, and you're going to be creating blocks of functional blocks, or blocks of different type of experience. Of areas of expertise. So you're, instead of talking to your company, you're going to be talking about sales and marketing. You're going to be talking about PR. You're going to be, oh, another blog is going to be, you're going to be talking, for example, about whatever industry, airline. So you're going to create blogs by different type of areas of expertise. And you're going to be highlighting that experience instead of the companies that you are going to be working with. And again, a lot of people, they want to change sector, countries, they have gap years, they're still using chronological. And that could be one of the reasons. But the most important is whatever you use, chronological and functional. And I help a lot of my clients. They say, well, Nieves, but I study civil engineering. And one of my clients now is civil engineering, but I haven't done it in the last 10 years. I only did it for 1 year. I've been doing marketing, and that happens a lot, isn't it? I've been doing marketing during the last, whatever, seven years. And believe me, we can change without lying. We can change that chronological CV to functional CV, because it's about the experience that you have in your personal life and your professional life. And you can build a very solid functional CV if you actually want to make that change. The problem is when you regret, when it's too late, though I always think that it's never too late. But the problem is when you, maybe you're whatever, 50 or 60, then it's becoming to be a little bit late, but not never, never too late. So if you really, once you go through step one, if you really think you want to change the industry, or you want to move to another country, do not hesitate. Contact me if you need help, and we can change your chronological CV to a functional CV. But what is very important is, once you have your core CV or resume, it's very important before you apply for a vacancy, you adapt and you scan what the keywords of the job description, and you actually adapt your CV, because otherwise you are not gonna go through the filter of the, you know, what our colleague Hussam was explaining, the robot. I said the robot or the software. A lot of people ask me about, you know, it's 2 pages, 3 pages, only 2 pages, one side, please, only 2 pages, and it has to be clean. A lot of people, they use very glamorous CVs. Unless you're working in marketing, in photography, design, use a simple CV, something that stands out, is clean. And the structure, it has to be a profile description, which is your position in the statement that we have worked in the first step. That is very important. That's why that first step, believe me, is very important. We are going to use it here in the profile description or the elevator speech. Then the transferable skill is the second block. Again, very important. This is all the work we have done in the first step. We are going to take our transferable skill and that quality work you have done with yourself, doing the self-evaluation, believe me, is going to pay out here. Then one of the major mistakes I see is that a lot of people in their CV, they put a lot of responsibilities instead of achievements. So your responsibilities, they have to be a paragraph, 3-4 lines of paragraphs. The rest has to be key achievement. And that is actually what is lacking. And that is why the SOARs or the STARS, the achievements, a tool that I've shared with you before, is going to help you to come up with 20, 30 achievements for your professional career and also for your private life that you can use in your CV. So always you need to have a long list of achievements, starting with action verbs and with data. What I mean with data is with percentage, with sales, with the results. What was the result? That is the R, if you remember, SOAR or achievement, S-O-I-R. I said that we were going to use the R for the achievements in the TV. This is it. So again, it's very important the time you invest in the first part, because it's going to really pay out. And then the education courses and the languages. This is a list of some of the action verbs. Again, you need to start achievements, action verbs in past tense. And functional, as you can see, is exactly the same, but we are going to highlight the expertise, the areas of expertise. And again, we are going to use a lot of achievements. And only in the second page is when you put the years and the companies. So because most of the time, people will only scan the first page. If you have a gap year or you don't have experience in a specific sector and you're saying sector, that's why it's easier to be invited to the interview. And the cover letter, again, a lot of people, they don't use cover letter. Highly important, first to use it, and second to customize it, to personalize it as well. It's about using those keywords that you have seen in the job description. You always have to use it in the cover letter. And you need to make sure it's not gonna give you the role, but if you use one that is very catchy, they are gonna invite you to the interview. You're gonna stand out. And it has to be 4 paragraphs. Why you're writing the first one, the second is the qualification and achievements, why this will hire you, and request for an interview. That said, don't write these long letters, because you know they are not going to continue reading. So if you write a very long cover letter, actually you're going to end up with opposite results. So it's short and sweet, 4 paragraphs. Networking, STAR, very important. 80% of the roles, you will get them through your networking, through your contacts. A lot of people, they tell me, it's like, Nieves, but I've moved country and I don't have a lot of contacts. Your contacts, I don't mean that they're going to be offering your job. The contacts is your contacts in your life, in your professional life and in your personal life. That could be, you know, friends, you know, students at uni, the parents of your children, you know, family members, etc., etc. It's very important that you do this quadrant and you start thinking about all your contacts, you know, professionally speaking and personally speaking, because you never know when you start having these career conversations, you never know who is going to be offering you the job. So it's very important in the first step. You remember I told you about coming up with 20, 30 companies. This is the type of the script, and I have templates for this. You can actually have with your contacts, but before that, you have to do your own homework, which means you need to come up during that conversation with 20 or 30 companies that you want to target. And you have to really have career conversation with all your contacts. And it's not about asking them job, it's sharing with them your new project. And your new project is that you are in a new career project or career path, and you need to ask them for suggestions, and you need to ask them whether they know people in those 20 or 30 companies that are going to be your target market. And pretty much the same with the recruiters and the headhunters. It's a win-win relationship, and you really need to build that relationship with the headhunters. So going back again to the step number one, when you came up with those 5 headhunters or 10 headhunters, when you speak with them, you need to have this sell approach, which again is synthesize your message, explore the needs, link your skills and competencies to the project that they are handling, to the roles that they are handling, and secure, always secure the next meeting. So a smart approach with your contacts and sell approach with with the recruiters. But in the end, it's the same. It's really having a clear message of what is your goal. That's why it's very important to have a clear goal, because otherwise you're going to speak with them and they won't understand what you're trying to say. So it's very important to have that smart and sell approach. But in all cases, you need to really build relationship. What I see a lot of people, they do a lot of networking when they're looking for a job, and then they forget in the next 5 years, and then they need to start from scratch. So it's about being social. It's not just about having LinkedIn contacts. It's about actually building the relations and being a human being, and really building as well your personal brand. Because once you know what you want to do, when you have your CV, your cover letter, it's about making sure that people think about you, about the professional you want to be. Because at the end, your personal brand is what people think of you when you are not around. And it's when I always compare to what Gandhi says, with all my respect, is when what you think, what you say, and what you do are in harmony. And if you learn to sell what you work, you will never have to sell yourself again. So talking about LinkedIn, very important. Again, LinkedIn, as you know, again, going about the keywords, same as the CV and the cover letter, LinkedIn even more, you need to make sure you use those keywords that you find in the job description you want to apply for. And this is starting with the title. The title, the four first words that are very important, because in those first four words, you really need to use the words that you want to be fine for. So you want to be whatever, finance manager, you need to make sure that in those first four letters, no words of your title, you have finance manager, because that's going to increase your ranking. And so that's very important. Very professional picture on the background, on your personal profile. Important as well, a lot of people, they don't know they can customize their URL. Most of the people, they have their names and some of the numbers. You can remove the numbers, but what would help you as well is actually put again the title what you want to be found for. For in my case would be coaching and consulting. I could put Nieves Rodriguez as well, but you can put again airline manager, you can put finance manager, Diana, for example, and then telephone and email again. A lot of people, they are very lazy recruiters, HR managers, so make sure you have your telephone number. You will be surprised of how many people don't have telephone numbers. And the languages as well, especially if you're applying for roles that require language. And again, in the profile, your email, again, very important. So you have to make it easier. Skills, you can put up to 50 skills, but people that are looking at you, they will only see 3. So you need to ensure, again, that you use the skills. So look at the 3 or 4 vacancies you would love to get a job for, and customize your CV, customize your cover letter, and customize your LinkedIn. And you can make sure that you have the skills that they are required for those roles, and you can actually rank them. And if you apply for a job, if you have premium LinkedIn, you will see they do a match, and they will tell you you have 1 of the skills or 5 of the skills out of 10. So you can actually go back, add the new skills if you have still spare ones, or you can replace one for the other. And as for recommendation, this is like trip advisory. I mean, people, they are going to be looking, I tell you, they're going to be looking in your profile, and they're going to look for recommendation. How is it to work with, you know, with Diana, with Paul, with John, with Nieves? So just make sure you have recommendation and you give recommendations. As I mentioned, be social. When you send a contact, 90% of people that request contact, they wouldn't open unless you put a reason. So when you send a contact, just put something that is brief. You have a 300 characters here, but you can actually put a reason. And actually, one of the things I really want you to remember is every time you apply for a job, you need to contact. So apply for a job, customize your CV, contact someone, look in your network, in LinkedIn or in your face-to-face or by phone or WhatsApp, especially in LinkedIn when you can see your first level, your second level. Look for those contacts and always contact someone in the company that actually, even if they are not involved in the hiring process, but believe me, I've been hiring people a lot that I got the CV from someone else, not directly to me. So never underestimate the networking, because again, 80% of the roles are filled by, but network. So it's very important that you build that conversation, that sell conversation, the smart conversation, and build your LinkedIn. Again, every time you apply, customize your CV, and TTP, talk to people. And that means over the phone, WhatsApp, or contacted someone in LinkedIn. And last but not least, step number three, the before, the during, the after the interview. In the first step, again, it's very important to see what you want to do. Second step is the personal brand. You have aligned your message, CV, personal letter, and LinkedIn. And interview, I'm not going to be talking about interview skills because, or different types of interview, because that's 100, especially now with Zooms, Skypes, et cetera, there are a lot of them. What I'm going to tell you is, and this is a proven system, if you work on your source, in your achievements, no matter, and again, if you work on your source, no matter what type of interview, you are going to be successful. So source could be a little bit painful. They are very easy, but it requires time because sometimes we are not used to remember our achievements, especially if we have been in a role for so long, we tend to forget. So one of the things I want you to remember, please, is from now on, keep your achievements, your log of your achievements, and keep your contacts always, always up to date. Three things I'm going to ask you in the interview, and probably this won't surprise me. Tell me about yourself. I got it wrong. The salary question. Sorry, this is the salary question. A lot of people, they come to an interview without actually getting prepared for what is the salary they want to get. Always, always, always defer, postpone the salary question. Try not to answer the question. Tell about the project you want to grow. You're looking for your next career move. But never talk about the salary because, you know, you really want to postpone that conversation until actually you're in the final stages or until they actually offer you a job, because in that moment, you have more power to negotiate a good salary. So always try to postpone. If they keep asking, then your strategy should be, you know, ask them about the, you know, what is the minimum and maximum they were thinking about a position. So ask them to reveal. And then if they continue insisting, is actually reveal what is your expected salary. But always try to postpone until they actually offer you a job. Exit message. A lot of people do not prepare exit message. And that's highly important, especially if you finish a relationship with your former employer and or you had issues and you still have very emotional, believe me, that's going to come up in the interview. So really make sure, and this is another example, you practice the exit message. Never talk bad in negative about your former boss or colleagues or company. And you have to be the best politician. Always turn it around. I always, you know, tell them the truth, but you have to be very, very cautious of the words you use and always, you know, prepare it very well, because the last thing you want to do is to have your emotions. And a lot of people, believe me, they make a big mistake about not preparing the exit message, not preparing the salary conversation. So just turn it around and make sure you talk about the career path and the next move in a positive way, and talk about your experience, how much you learn, your transferable skills that you develop, and how positively you're looking for your next career move. And then again, this is the salary. And then in the interview, it's very important after the interview, and tell me about yourself is the position in the statement that we talk in step number one. Okay, tell me about yourself, the salary question, and the exit, three things you need to prepare. And the fourth thing is the thank you. And I insist here because I still see a lot of people, they don't send you a thank you letter without the 24 hours. And it's an opportunity for you to really stand out. Once you finish the interview, and you know, I always suggest you have a notebook during the interview so you can write down your feelings after you finish the interview, and you write down anything that you committed to send back, or anything that you, any answer that you didn't feel that you handle properly. So thank you within the 24 hours actually makes you to stand out, allows you to really clarify anything that maybe they have any doubt about your skills or about your knowledge, allows you also to follow up on anything you need to follow up. And also always when you write letters, when you write emails during a job hunting or job search process, always try to close another conversation or another interview. But in any case, always you need to build all those relationships, like the star of the sword, the accomplishments. Always, you know, I want you to remember something because I know you are going to be successful if you do it. Build relationship with headhunters, with your network, and always keep a log of your accomplishment, because believe me, that's gonna pay off for you. And then always, you know, if you've been in contact with people, et cetera, always send a thank you letter to everyone that actually helped you during the process. So in summary, first is what you want to do. Have this less is more. Have very clear what you want to do. Create your personal brand and communication plan, and adjust all your resume, the cover letter. Always keep your network active, prepare yourself for the interview, prepare a good position and statement, elevator pitch, the SOAR, the 2030 SOARs, remember exit message, please do not forget, tell me about you, tell me about yourself, the position and statement, the salary conversation, please come prepared to an interview with a salary question, and the thank you after the interview. So now I'm going to tell you a little bit, or let's review why you were here. You know, some of you told me and you contacted me before because you didn't have clarity of what you want to do. Some of you, you know, were not sure about what type of CV or cover letter, resume you have to use. Some of you are applying for many roles, but they don't invite you to an interview. Or you're having many interviews, but never get an offer. So I think the question now is, if you're going to be continue using the time-consuming and old method, or are you actually going to switch to the system that works? And believe me, this system works. Is a system that Lee Harrison, the consulting company, uses as well. And this is the system that works. You need this to follow. And as you can see, it's simple, but you really need to shift. It is the system that works for the rest of your career. I can tell you that. It's going to give you the clarity because you're going to have very clear idea when you want to do. It's going to give you the confidence of you want to do, because you're going to build on your accomplishments of your transferable skills. It's going to help you to be productive and avoid frustration, because you're going to do less, but less is more, less is better, and you're going to have better result, you are going to be more effective, and you're going to get the job, because, you know, being more effective, meaning that you're going to do it with better quality, you're going to be invited more interviews, and if you're invited to more interviews, you're going to get the job. It is said that on average, you need to be invited to 5 interviews to actually to get a job. So that is your goal, but you need to be consistent. Successful people are consistent, and I want you to be successful being efficient and being consistent, following on those goals. So I'm going to share with you this framework. What I've shared with you is the framework and the templates that if you use them, you will be successful. But again, it's about, you know, choosing, and this is your area of control, choosing to be a victim or an actor or an actress of your life. But if you want to take control of your life, this is something I want to share with you. And that's why I share with you that link earlier, and we are going to get into the questions, any questions you may have now. So if you really want to have 30 tools, I've shown you some of them, but if you want to have 30 tools and templates, editable templates of the CV, the cover letter, you know, how to apply to an interview, the thank you letter, you know, letter with recruiters, et cetera, to really smash your job search in one click. And this weekend you have it, you have the quick link, and you will have all the tools to do that self-assessment, all the tools and templates to really be effective in your job search. You can have it in this link, up to 30 editable templates and tools that we have covered and more. And also CV in Spanish and English. A lot of people that were asking me about CV in Spanish, so I've included them in this link, template job search. And in the past, it was £49, the 30 tools and the templates. But for the people that are attending for you, this masterclass, I really want to recognize, I'd really like to recognize people that they take action, they take risks. For the next 24 hours, you can get them, you know, in one click for $24.95, you know, if you go to templates job search. And you will have the system, you will have all the tools, you will have all the templates, just one click. So this weekend you have it all, and so you can leave behind all the frustrations. If you really want to go deeper and you really want to get career coaching sessions, also because I like to recognize people that they take action and they take risk, and people that they take that first step, because I strongly believe, and you know, I wrote that book, Screw Procrastination, Take Action, that people that actually take action, they are the ones that, you know, make changes in the world. And just for being here, but only to 5 people, I can offer that, because you know, I also have a tight agenda. I offered you six sessions of career coaching with me, personalized, instead of £5, £10, £50 for you, just for attending this masterclass, if you book in the next 24 hours. So instead of £5, £10 is £2.55. And believe me, you're not gonna see this again. I can go with you hand by hand in all your process, do role plays for the interviews, adapt your CV, your cover letter with you, help you to reach out to recruiters, help to build your LinkedIn, and many, many other things. So you can book with the promo code 50%, and that is the link as well, that you will get it by email. So, and remember that you only live once, and every day is your life in miniature. Live your life in your own terms, because your life is your story at the end. And it's the opportunity to actually design your future, design your life, and you know, do not regret, you know, 10 years or 20 years from now. And I really hope you write your best seller. So thank you very much for your time. As now is, you know, I'm going to go through the rest of their questions, and I'm going to drink water a lot. Knowing the hiring manager, I'm going to read them out loud so everyone can learn, if that's okay. I'm not going to say the names, because we want to be in a safe environment. Knowing the hiring manager in a company you would like to join, what shall I ask to promote myself? Why shall I ask to promote myself? Well, actually, I guess what you're asking, Justin, correct me if I'm wrong, is if you can contact that person. Definitely, yes. I mean, again, 80% of the roles, they are filled out by our network. So it's very important that you actually make contact with that person, if I'm getting you right. So definitely reach out. In one of the letters I show you is a letter for the recruiters, or one of the templates is, you know, is a letter for hiring managers as well. And definitely reach out and tell, depending if, you know, how close you are to that person. You can do it verbally, or you can do it in writing, or you can do it in both. I always suggest to do it in both, and actually highlight that you have interest in the role. And again, remember those, you know, email or letter in four paragraphs, you know, why you're writing or why you are making a contact, and highlighting your experience, your achievement, and then mapping out, you know, what you can offer, what they are looking for. But definitely reach out and actually have that career conversation, that sell conversation, similar to what you will have with a recruiter, highlighting, you know, your message, your positioning statement, your elevator pitch, basically. So it's very important that in your case, you reach out and work on your elevator pitch. I hope that answers your question. Let me know if that's the case, if I got it wrong. If I can put the one someone is asking me, if I can put this, the link, yeah. You will get it. This is the, let me put it here again, sorry. This is the, this is the templates. Yeah, someone asked me to, thank you for the wonderful presentation. My question is, thank you for attending. It's a lot of content, and I'll always try to go through it and make sure we cover everything. My question is whether you will make these presentation slides available. Yes, I will send the video tomorrow morning. You know, it takes time until it's uploaded in YouTube, and I'll send it to you. If that's okay. So tomorrow morning you will have it in your inbox. Let me see. You well, let me see. I don't want to miss any currently part-time job. Oh, it's okay here. Can you turn a project into your career? I think that was on the question. My answer was definitely yes. Somehow is how I end up in studying my coaching master, and how is I end up doing my own company, opening my own company. And that is because I really always enjoyed helping people. I really always enjoyed developing people and, you know, doing all this analysis of my self-evaluation. And, you know, I realized that that's what I liked. And, you know, so I decided to take that U-turn that I was mentioning before. So definitely yes. And again, we need to follow our flow. We need to follow our light. We need to be happy because we spend a lot of hours, and sometimes, you know, we stay in our comfort zone until we realize sometimes it's never late again, but sometimes it's, you know, we don't realize how many hours we could be wasting our time, wasting our energy, and wasting our talents. Let me go down. Knowing the manager, yes. More and more job descriptions say must have a stable career history. Yes. My experience is very varied, as I took some time out to work in the charity sector. How do I get noticed and show that I'm really ready to start my career? Well, that's a challenging one. You could maybe, I will need to have more details, but you could maybe need, I don't know if you're using the chronological CV or functional CV. You may need to change it to a functional CV, but I will need more details, because that's the good thing about the functional CV. You start talking about your areas of expertise, and they don't, in the first page, you don't see the chronological order or those gaps. But also as a volunteer job, also, you know, again, it's work. Whether it's a charity or not charity, paid or not paid, that's a different thing, but that's a work. So, you know, another option would be actually to put it in there if you are going to continue, and if some of the transferable skills that you've used in that work, because at the end you were working, actually will help you in the next career move. If it's completely different, then my suggestion would be to change. If you have a chronological assuming you have a chronological CV, my suggestion would be to change it to a functional CV. And that's absolutely possible because I'm sure working in the charity, you've learned a lot of things. Sorry, yeah, I was going to move. This is the template for CEP, again, third template, and this is the career coaching. Again, you will not see this again, and I know a lot of people need it now, so definitely for the ones attending today, which is a big group, only to five, I can actually, the first five, I can actually offer this opportunity because I don't have enough time. Otherwise, I would love more questions. This is the fun part. This is the fun part of the presentation. So I'm all ears, but I'm going to drink some water. Okay. Until when? Yes, until when? Two things is until you will get it by email and you will get the presentation by email, the video tomorrow. When it's in, uploaded in YouTube, it takes a little bit time. And these two offers, both the templates, they're always available with that link, but in different price, it's 49 instead of 24 until tomorrow night. And the coaching session definitely always available as well, but totally a different price. And until tomorrow night at 255. If anyone need some kind of financial help, meaning paying in installments or something, especially the coaching, because I know it's a good amount. I understand what we all going through, and I'm happy to talk to you and happy to look at different options with you if that would help. That's all I can do. Thank you very much for the effort, and I'm gonna search for all my 23rd strengths. Good. What is your opinion about humor? Should I mention that I'm a funny one? I love that question. And do not mention, but you're during the research you're going to do before going for an interview, you're going to see the culture of the company. And I will actually suggest to go during lunchtime or at the end of the shift to the company to see what the company culture is, how the people there dress up, et cetera, et cetera. And actually you will get a sense on about how the sense of humor is accepted in an organization or in a company. I personally speaking, when I do interviews, I always ask about sense of humor because I think it's highly important in a company and in the team to have sense of humor. So I wouldn't suggest though to mention you're funny. A different thing is a sense of humor. Because I had a completely different experience with someone that I was during an interview, he was trying to be funny. And he was not successful. He was finalist, but he was not successful. Because depending on the company or the culture, in the end, an interview, so you have to be very careful about being funny or making jokes during an interview. And the person I'm talking about here was actually making jokes, which I don't think it was appropriate, but definitely sense of humor, 100%, 100%. That's about emotional intelligence. That is one of the things I wrote in my book, Mindfulness at Work. That is in Amazon if you want to search for it. And sense of humor definitely helps with the resilience and self-humor definitely helps with emotional intelligence. So definitely humor, highly important. Totally agree. It is nice to reach a person via LinkedIn that we are connected, but I don't know him. Yes, definitely. Yes, of course. That's why we have LinkedIn, definitely. I think we all have people that are, we are connected, but we don't know personally. Definitely, just reach out again. Always say why. I mean, I like your profile. Are you or your part of a company I have interest in? Or I like the articles that you publish. Always give a reason, and then you start having that type of conversation, and always tell why you are reaching out. Definitely, yes, totally appropriate. If you're not premium, I'm not affiliate of LinkedIn or anything like that, but if you're really serious about, it's an investment, But if you're really serious about your job search or your career move, if you are consistent, reaching out people, as I mentioned, apply for a role, customize your CV, cover letter, and LinkedIn, and contact. That should be, you know, always the order. Definitely a LinkedIn premium, I would say, is for you, because it really gives you more opportunity to reach out to people, but you have to use it right. And it pays out. You know, again, 80% of people, they get jobs through contacts. And that doesn't, I don't mean by friends. I mean by networking, doing networking in LinkedIn. So definitely go for it. Go for it. Good question. I also love the question about the humor. Because I always include it in my interview questions, and that's a very good question to ask a candidate. And not many candidates are ready to answer that question. So always come prepared to answer a questions about sense of humor. Thank you. Thank you for the time. Thank you for making time to attend this masterclass. I know everyone is absolutely busy. I know we are all attending a lot of Zoom calls and webinars. So that's why I always try to put all my knowledge in what you can put in 1 hour. And because I'm very respectful with your time. I'm very respectful with your knowledge. And I'm really respectful of, you know, of a person that takes risk and, you know, really wants to learn like you guys, and is going through, you know, this new career path or career change. So again, thank you very much. I don't think we have any questions. You're keeping well. Yes, Jude, nice to see you. Thank you for joining, Jude. And please reach out if you have any questions about the templates and the tools that you have until tomorrow. Reach out if you need any sort of help or financing regarding coaching. I'm here to help if I can't. And reach out if you have any questions, any comments, and definitely you will have tomorrow the video. Again, thank you for your time. I hope I've contributed a little bit in your job hunting. That was the goal. And let's keep in touch. Thank you very much. Have a good evening. Bye.